This fellow's paper shredder from some colleagues. I just have a quick look. It's been opened previously. Basic fault here is this gear here stripped, and well, obviously, drivetrain has been disassembled. Some nice metal gears that could prove useful. Some metal plates that work against each other to shred the paper. I'm not sure if I have a use for it specifically, but again, those are going to be hardened and possibly useful. I don't know. And then what looks like an induction motor, single phase induction motor. We'll have a look in that. Pretty much what you look like. Looks pretty much like what you get in the fan. So it should have a capacitor somewhere. Let's see if I can find that. Actually, it isn't. I'll take that back. This is definitely not an induction motor. Induction motors do not use brushes. So my next guess would be a universal motor, which makes sense. At high start and torque, could run on AC voltage, run on DC voltage. Makes sense for a device like this. Pieces now, the motor is out and separated. A couple screws here, a couple circ clips there to come out, gears came out. The metal gears on the side are actually looking great. Quite nice pair there, three actually. And then this side, just some circ clips for the shafts that are going through. That's holding these metal pieces here. And they all offset at some different angles. So they all basically grab at different times. So you reduce the amount of power that you're taking at any point in time. What's amazing about this is this glue. This, well, I'm saying glue. This is actually this lubrication. It's thick like glue. It's not going to actually run away. But it's kind of tacky, pretty tacky. This is the first time I've seen grease this tacky. So their lubrication system is a little different from what I would have expected. But again, very, very simple device. And what they've done is they've had one switch on some side here. They've had another switch for putting it on and off the device, forward and reverse. And this third one is actually a safety switch that they had. So that it was in the bottom of your device, and if you didn't put it into the bin that it came with, it wouldn't contact this one, so it wouldn't come on. So pretty much, you had to put on this and this for it to work. I'll have a look at this one and see what this one actually does in the whole mix of it. It's an interesting wiring system, so some a little bit of research on this motor.